My dear friend, it has been brought to my attention that some of our members don't understand that the Chamber of Fire won't open for them until they have walked on the path of Shore and studied Shore's holy relic. Remember that we have to guide our flock. Members wishing to advance to level 3 have to pass a test. The testing device has been installed in my apartment on the 4th floor. If a member is deemed worthy of level 3, please give him or her a key to my apartment. The instructions for the test can be found in my apartment. Based on a hidden note that someone found, we know that we have about 3 or 4 traitors in our midst. We will deal with them one by one and destroy every message as we find them. Please keep your eyes peeled and report suspicious activity. Apparently, some members are afraid of Shore spiders. Please let those people know that the spiders won't harm them. Well, unless they sin, of course. If they see someone getting attacked by Shore spiders, that person is a sinner and therefore the attack is justified. One of our members was attacked by Skull, and the only defense that we have against him is our faith in Shore. If someone gets attacked by Skull and there is no priest around to help him or her, I suggest self-punishment. Punishing yourself in the name of Shore should send a strong message to Skull that you will not fall for him and that you are indeed a child of Shore. My dear friend, it has been brought to my attention that some of our members don't understand that the Chamber of Fire won't open for them until they have lost.
is it not beautiful? A piece of art. This sacred relic that you see here once stood in Shor's holy temple. He built this with his own hands. I want you to study it. I want you to look at it for hours on end. If you stare at the relic long enough, you will be enlightened. Why did we build the... Why do we have to walk for Shor? After Shor was sent to Earth by the Old Ones, he spent many years wandering around. He was looking for a place to settle down. He was looking for people that would believe in him, that would bow down to him, that would worship him, and accept him as their new Lord and Savior. But he found no one. The people were too blind to see him for who he truly was, a god amongst men. And thus he was wandering, year after year after year, until after many years Shor stumbled into a village that was suffering. The people were starving. Shor cast a spell and fed them. It was then that the god amongst men, they worshipped him, they bowed to him, they built him a temple, and Shor could finally settle down.
Be in good shape and follow your beloved Shor.
You are a sinner, and now both Shor spiders and spiders.
Did you expect me to just let you walk away? Sure, spiders are hungry and they will feast on your flesh.
Members wishing to advance to level 3 have to pass a test. The testing device has been installed in my apartment on the 4th floor. If a member is deemed worthy of level 3, please give him or her a key to my apartment. The instructions for the test can be found in my apartment.
Thank you.
sit on your golden throne. Oh, shore, my lord and savior. Let me take from the fountain of youth. Oh, my sacrifice, you will honor, I know. Don't let me lose my way. Let me suffer for you as you have suffered for us so many years ago. Rule, oh shore, rule with a rod of iron. My sacrifice will set you free, and let me live eternally. I wish to serve you forever and ever.
We could live in paradise
on the foreman's
abandoned shore, and they betrayed him, and they followed Skoro. This sin has been passed on from one generation to the next, and now it is up to us to suffer. This is why we all are born in sin and must pray for forgiveness. Skoro is still around us. He is trying to seduce us with his promise of everlasting life. But don't fall for him. Don't follow him, for Shore hates sinners, and sinners will burn. Shore loves you with all his heart if you stay on the right track. But if you decide to abandon him, if you decide to follow Skoro, then Shore will destroy you. For Shore hates sinners. If you sin, my priests will punish you. They will push you to your limits. But they don't punish you because they hate you. They punish you because they hope that Shore will forgive you if he sees that you are willing to suffer for him. And maybe, maybe if you are lucky, Shore will once again welcome you in his arms. For when the day comes, we will stand in front of him, and he will...